Lifestyle Screens Leveling the Door. In this video, you're going to learn how to level the door. In this exaggerated graphic, you can see that the door is not resting level in the opening. There's an easy fix for this, and we're going to show you how to correct this condition. The easiest way to check the door is with a level, but there's another way you can check because nearly every garage door is level at the top of the door opening. The quickest visual reference to see if the door is level is to compare the distance between the spline groove and the garage door's weather seal. In this case, you can see that the door is down about 3/8 of an inch at the one end. So what you'll need to do is shim the door up on this end. It's a good idea to have a variety of shims to place under the door so that you arrive at the correct shim thickness for the door's leveling needs. So as you see here, the distance between the spline groove and the garage door's weather seal is uniform, thus indicating a level door. So what you have to do now is replace the wooden shim with something more permanent of the same thickness. The perfect product for this is what's called backer rod. Backer rod is a closed cell foam that does not absorb moisture. This is important so that it does not change the balance of your door by absorbing moisture. It's not a bad idea to have several diameters of backer rod at your disposal to accommodate a variety of leveling needs that you may encounter while installing lifestyle screen doors. Here's a view of the door out of the opening showing you where to install the backer rod in the lifestyle screen door. Typically, 4 or 5 feet is enough backer rod to level the screen door on one end.